Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today we are going to learn former letters of the Persian alphabet. Ain, Ghain, Kaf, and Gaf. For now, just know that Ain has a couple of different forms depending on where in the word it's going to appear. Same applies to Ghain. Okay, just a quick explanation. There is no such a thing as the sound ain or ah in English, but you will get used to it the more you see examples. Don't worry, I'm going to explain. Okay, we're going to get started with ain, and you will see how this letter appears in words and how its form changes according to where in the word it's going to be. Okay, so the sound is kind of like ah, it's like a stop, glottal stop, but it's not as strong as it is in Arabic, like ah, right? So please do not pronounce it as ah, because this is Persian, not Arabic. It's simply just ah, like normal ah. Here we have the word asal, which means honey. So if you notice, this letter can also show up in this kind of rectangular form in the middle of a word, when it appears in the middle of a word. So for example, here we have the word mu'allim, mu'allim, which means teacher. So as you can see, we have the e, the ain, appearing in the middle. That's why it kind of looks like a triangle, mu'allim. Okay, so if you start the word with ain, you have a different form, but if it appears in the middle of the word, it looks like a triangle. Of course, there's also a possibility that ain comes at the end of a word. So here you have the triangle, but you also have to kind of close the loop. So as you can see, this is like ain at the end of a word, as is here, for example, the word manba, manba. So I'm putting that little tiny apostrophe just to make sure that you understand this is slightly different from just a, but you don't need to worry about it. It's just, you know, just pronounce it as manba. It's really just a regular a for most English speakers. Make sure that you consider both of these categories and know where you're supposed to use them. This one especially appears at the end of a word if it's not connected. Right, so for example, no, the word no, here again we have the letter ein at the end, but because this cannot be connected or joined to the previous letter, it kind of appears in a separate form, no. All right, so it depends really what's happening in the entire word, and based on that you can make a decision which version of ein you're supposed to use. So, and now we're going to move to the next one. Okay, so basically the next one, in terms of word formation and how it's going to appear in words, will be 100% similar to this one. The only difference is the sound is different and there's one dot on top. So this one is rain and the sound is re. So basically the sound is really similar to the sound re, the glottal re, that we learned in a previous video. We're going to now look at some examples. We have the word morg, morg. Now the word morg means hen or chicken. Now if this letter appears at the beginning of a word like gaz, gaz, which means goose, another bird, gaz, we have to write it like this, the short form, so qaz. As you can see, the letter ghain looks kind of cut because it's at the beginning, has come at the beginning of a word. So the next one happens when this letter comes in the middle of a word. So for example, we have maqaze, maqaze, which actually means shop. We have borrowed it from the French magasin. And maqaze basically is written with that version of rain that you can see looks like a kind of triangle with a dot on top. Now, the same letter can also appear at the end of a word, but kind of connected, like tiq, the word tiq, which means razor or thorn, right? So tiq, that's the sound at the end, tiq. Okay, now we're going to focus on the next one, which is kaf, the letter kaf. And the sound is kind of like K in English. And we're going to look at some examples. This one is much easier because there are only two forms. So, the first example I have for you is the word kar, kar, which basically means work or job or action. It's interesting if you pay attention to the fact that the word kar is connected also to the word karma in English. Originally, the word comes from Sanskrit. So, it's related to acting and action and doing something. The next example is tak, the word tak. Now, tak in Farsi means unique. It's like something that's only, you know, one and only. It's something quite unique. So, we say tak. If you refer to something as take, it is unique, or someone as take, he or she is unique. It means you're showing admiration for that person or for that thing. So, now we're going to focus on the next letter that really looks like kaf. The only difference is one little extra line on top. Now we have gaf. If you have, for example, the word gol, as you can see in Farsi, we have to use the short form of ge at the beginning. Gol, which means flower. We also have another example for the long version, the complete version, which is sag. Now the word sag means dog. This one is easy, right? Because sag, dog, right? You can remember both ways. It's gonna end in ge. So, I think that's really it. And we're going to have a quick look and the last part, just, you know, summarizing everything we have learned today very quickly before I start recording the next video for you. So, here we have the letter Ain, the letter Gain, then we have the letter Kaf, K, and Gaf, which actually sounds G, right? So, basically this is all you have for today. I hope you keep practicing. Now, remember, if you pay attention actually, you know, to how each of these letters sounds, you're going to be able to identify them in new words that you're going to see. Okay? So keep practicing. Until then, khodafez.